These four beasts that come up are now described, and they're omitted in the lesson, but they are described in verse 4, Daniel, in verse 4 to verse 7. And to be as brief as I can about it, we have this. The first was like a lion. That'll be England. It had eagle's wings. And that lion kingdom is the English kingdom. That's the English Empire that takes place after the Roman Empire goes to pieces, and during the Church Age, England takes over. That'll come in with the Reformation and the King James Bible. And the lion that comes in there is interesting, because when the Antichrist shows up, he's likened to three animals. Now, the Antichrist is right on the stage, backstage just a little bit, waiting to come on the stage any time the UN's ready for him, and they welcome him. And God, as usual, likens him to an animal. Now, when the Antichrist shows up, he shows up after these kingdoms that come in, and the first of these is a lion, and it's England. When the Antichrist shows up, you know what he's told, what you're told about him? You're told about him that he's like a leopard. And you're told him that in the likeness of him, this beast that comes up the last time, the Antichrist, he has a head like a lion. And he has feet like a bear. And the rest of him is a leopard. That's Revelation chapter 13, verse 1 to 4. And those are the animals that are listed right here. A leopard, and a bear, and a lion. Now, what does this mean? Well, it means something none of the expositors caught, or the prophets, conservative, saved, or lost. It means there has to be an English-speaking lion. Because the lion here represents the British Empire. So your natural, your universal language when the Lord comes back is English. If you don't believe it, just study your computers and study your nets and webs and stuff and see what you're talking about. Now, that leopard that comes up, he likes the Antichrist to a leopard. That leopard doesn't have a lion's back or stomach or chest or legs or feet or tail, but his mouth is that of a lion. It's an English-speaking beast. And after World War II, Englishmen dropped from a first-rate power to a second, third, fourth, and now about a fifth-rate power. They're through. But he has feet like a bear. See that thing? Daniel 7, a second like to a bear. Daniel 7:5, another beast a second like to a bear. That's Russia. That's the man that walks like a bear. And you're told there in your passage, if you study Daniel chapter 7, you'll find that he has three ribs in his mouth. That's Lithuania and Latvia and Estonia. Three of them. And when they tried to break up from the Communist Union, they right away attacked them and tried to keep them back in. And the British Empire is through. Britannica no longer ruled the waves. The communists rule the waves. Who was the first to go? The whole nation of Russia. Off they went, and China followed suit. And then Vietnam followed suit, and then North Korea followed suit. And now perhaps the greatest communist nation in the world heading up is America. At least according to Pravda, the Russian newspapers. The Russian newspapers in Russia admit now the greatest movement toward communism is America. That's the bear. It came from Russia. Now look at the next one. Verse 5, after this I beheld, and another beast like a leopard came up, and had on the horn in the back the fowl for wings of a fowl, and the beast also had four heads, and dominion was given to him, and so forth and so on. Now he's likened here to a leopard. Now that's the last kingdom before the Antichrist shows up. And that's why the Antichrist is likened to a leopard, and a bear, and a lion in Revelation 13. You say, why? Because of your lesson today, Daniel 7. All the scholars missed it. The saved ones and the lost ones. It's amazing. It's amazing the power the devil has to get cold people who mess with that book.